So this is computer water damage tip number one. As soon as you get the computer open and onto your workbench, you're gonna wanna flip the computer over just in case there's still some liquid inside. Now the liquid would have hit the keyboard, and now because it's upside down, it has a chance to actually drip onto the screen. Better it sit on the top of the display rather than the other side of this board and create possible corrosion. And this is computer water damage tip number one. Computer water damage repair tip two is to, once you have the computer open, you're gonna wanna look very carefully for areas where you can see that there's evidence of the spill. So in this case, coffee coming through the actual computer. So in this area, if I compare it to the bottom of the case, I can see some here, I can see some there. So I mean, these are indications of where to look, where I may see potential evidence of the coffee coming through. And then I can address it with a lightly damp rubbing alcohol rag. And in this case, I mean, this entire board is gonna have to come out, and then I'll have to inspect the other side in order to make sure that there's no coffee residue left anywhere on the motherboard. But this is definitely the second most important thing you wanna do, is find evidence of where the spill, like you see, that has to be cleaned off, this has to be cleaned off, and I'm sure there's a lot more on the other side because this was a crazy spill. Computer water damage repair tip three. This is not an easy process. So if you're not absolutely super confident in your ability to open a computer, diagnose water damage, and repair it, it might be easier to consult a professional in order to avoid further heartache. If you really want your computer fixed and you're not sure if you can do it, probably a good idea to involve a professional. And this is computer water damage repair tip number three. Computer water damage repair tip four is to pick a workspace and area to disassemble the computer once you decide to do so, that's not gonna have to be moved mid-repair. And that'll be okay for a few days so that you can keep all your tools, screws, removed components in order, and hopefully put them back together in the same order that they were removed. And this is computer water damage repair tip number four. Computer water damage repair tip five is to fully disconnect or even remove the battery in order to cease power to all your internal components, so that while cleaning or disassembling the computer, you don't short any of these very delicate internal components. And this is computer water damage repair tip five. Computer water damage repair tip number six is that if the data on the water damage machine is important, then finding and removing the SSD or hard disk drive that contains the data is an absolute priority. You're gonna wanna find it, remove it, and hopefully you can use an external enclosure to extract the data with another computer. You may not be able to fix the water damage machine, but if you can salvage the data, that's at least a win. And this is computer water damage repair tip number six. Computer water damage repair tip number seven is that once you have the entire computer disassembled, you're going to want to inspect each and every single component separately. So I can see a little bit of the coffee spill here, so I'm going to use some rubbing alcohol in order to clean that. So I mean, just look at each component separately and make sure you can identify which components have the spill and which don't, and what areas need to be cleaned. And this is computer water damage repair tip number seven. Computer water damage repair tip number eight is that before and after cleaning with rubbing alcohol, so cleaning off the residue that you found inside the computer, you're gonna wanna give it time to dry. So allow time, once you entirely open the computer, give it time to dry, hit it with the rubbing alcohol on a slightly damp rag, and then give it more time to dry. And sometimes a fan can even help. If you can position a small fan, let's say beside running over the area that was cleaned, give it enough time before you start to put the computer back together. And this is computer water damage repair tip number eight. Computer water damage repair tip number nine is to inspect each component for possible residue of the spill itself. And then you're gonna wanna go ahead and use rubbing alcohol on a slightly dampened rag. Now, you'll wanna choose the percentage of your rubbing alcohol depending on what area of the computer you're trying to clean. So 50% is gonna dry a lot slower than 99%. If I was cleaning, let's say, the processor, which in this case, thankfully, the coffee didn't reach any of the processors, I'd use 99%. Now, some of the case areas, which I've already cleaned, I dampened with 50%, and I squeezed it out to make sure that my paper towel is not over wet or over dampened. And then there's going to be a couple of areas where I can see the coffee residue that'll have to get cleaned out. Just take your time, be careful. And this is computer water damage repair tip number 9. Computer water damage repair tip number 10 is to use a fan in order to run over components that you've cleaned from the spill residue using rubbing alcohol. Now, sometimes a fan like this can be enough. Let it sit for a few hours, run over the component you clean. Sometimes you'll need a bigger fan, something like this. But it's always a good idea to give it enough time to dry, especially after you've cleaned a potentially damaged component. And this is computer water damage repair tip number 10. So this computer's been on for the last 4 hours now, streaming 1080p off YouTube at 60% brightness. The temperature is stable at 35 Celsius. So I mean, that's definitely the new thermal compound. All in all, it looks like this computer water damage repair was successful. Hit that like and subscribe button if you guys found value, and stay tuned for more tech-related DIY videos to come in the future. Appreciate all the support. Stay safe out there, guys.